Righto, Jono's coming here to take us back in time with his What in... Yeah.
Roll over, read all about it. It happened this week-ish.
What in the... happened this week?
Hello,
what in
Dan.
The world happened
Hello.
This week?
Welcome back.
Hello, Jono.
Hello, everybody.
Good Weave morning. Us a good morning. Picture.
Andrew Bolt, if you're watching, I know you're there. Because he's a big fan
you're
of this thing.
You're a bit obsessed with him, aren't you?
Well, I have been stalking him for many years, but that's my problem. I wanted to talk to you about Bikini Atoll.
Oh.
Because in this week in history, 1946, we exploded the atom bomb on Bikini Atoll. Yeah. There it is. I think Channel 9 used to start their news with that, or maybe Channel 7.
Now known as Bikini Atoll.
That's where Bikini Atoll used to be. And also in 1946 when they experimented with the atom bomb. Look at those poor little ships. Oh, looks like a special effect from a...
Michael Bay film.
Michael Bay. I was going to say Michael Bay film.
I hope they're wearing sunglasses.
No, yes, of course. That'll protect you, those sunglasses. Mm. But also the bikini was invented by a French fashion designer, the two-piece bikini, which nobody wanted to wear, so they actually had to get a exotic dancer from one of the Paris casinos to model it for. That's pretty bad. The guy who invented it was a sleazy old Frenchman, but I have no offence, by the name of Louis Riard, as opposed to André Riard.
What the?
Yeah, look at that.
That's very brave.
That's very risque.
By the banks of the Seine River.
The problem is they didn't invent the bikini line before they invented the bikini. Look at that, look at that.
We tried
good
to get...
Good two-tone, two-tone image there.
Isa to reenact these scenes for us when she went back to Paris recently, but she wouldn't be in it. She wouldn't be in it. It takes a lot more money than that, Jono, I'm afraid. So the bikini atoll on the bikini. Bikini from there's Louis there. Look at him. Hello, I have a great idea for a show.
Where's her belly button?
Oh my god.
They didn't have belly buttons in those
it's
days.
A mannequin.
Oh, it's a mannequin.
Also, 1975, of course, a lot of us are watching Wimbledon on another network at some stage. 1975, Wimbledon, the first man of colour won. Arthur Ashe won Wimbledon in 1975, and I think he beat Jimmy Connors.
Wow. Yeah, it was a big match.
It was amazing.
It was amazing. He was a great tennis player, Arthur Ashe.
And what a waspy sport to dominate in as well.
Yeah.
That was the one that the white people did very well at, and suddenly there was a black man doing it. So good on you, Arthur Ashe. And also, 1979, we had the Sony Walkman for all the young people on school holidays. This is a cassette, an audio cassette. Where you put it in your audio cassette player, a Sony Walkman. Mm. It's a Sony. And you could jog and you could run. This is the TV ad they used to use to launch it. That's a child of the time. 1970, that's like my two children, a bit like that.
Oh, so it was like an iPod, right?
Yeah, an iPod, but it had a cassette tape in it.
Do you remember the Discmans that came out not soon after, but you couldn't run with it because it could skip. jump.
I remember the Walkman came out. Oh my God, technology just doesn't get any better than
until you went over a bump.
We can all.
I remember getting a Walkman for my seventh when I was 7 year old as a Christmas present. I walked around all Christmas with headphones on. People would say, "And how was your Christmas?" And I'd say, "Great, thanks.
They had the double headphones where you can have a button on it going, this is great, isn't it? ELO! Fantastic. Celebrity birthdays. John Farnham's birthday tomorrow. He's 21 again. Aww. But before that, Glenn Shorrock, of course, from the Twilights and the Little River Band there. That's a photograph of him with his receding hairline.
He looks like a Doctor Who.
He's 70, isn't he?
He's, yes.
Jeez.
He's 70 today. He has looked like Glenn that Shorrock. For the last 50 years.
Mm. Another POM, another person that came over on the ship. Dan Aykroyd from the Blues Brothers and everything else. Dan's House of Blues. He's a fantastic Canadian. And, of course, my personal friend, I knew you'd like this one, Pamela Anderson. She kept me waiting an hour for that interview because she wanted to be made up for a radio interview.
She's 47, isn't she?
She's 47 in showbiz.
Wow. Is that all of her? Is all of her turning 47?
All of her, yes.
Okay, right.
Yeah, thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. It happened this week. Happy birthday, Farnham, tomorrow.
I can't believe. Did she do the whole interview in the robe, or did she say you'll have to speak up on wearing a towel?
No, that was at Claridge's Hotel in London. She kept just waiting for an hour because they said she's getting made up and she's just doing some TV later on, but she wants to look good for you guys. I'm going, does she know it's radio?
Thank you very much,
in slow motion, running in slow motion.